afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Class of 2010 Honors and Awards Program. I am Leo Rouse, Dean of the College of Dentistry, the Class of 1973. A few housekeeping comments. If you have a cell phone, please put them on vibrate or on non-noise, if you will. Please, I thank you for your support. Most appreciated. I want to welcome you to Howard University and welcome you to this most special program for our graduating class of 2010, Dental Hygiene and Dentistry. Thank you very much. At this time, I'd like to call for the invocation the Dean of Bowell Chapel, Dr. Bernard Richardson, the Dean of the Andrew Rankin Chapel.
Let us pray. Most gracious and loving God, in you we live, in you we move, and from you comes all the joy and the achievements that are before us on this day. We give thanks for the Howard University College of Dentistry. We give thanks for what this college has meant to our university, our nation, and the global community. By your grace, it has been and continues to be a beacon of hope, professionalism, and excellence. We give thanks for the administration, the faculty, and the staff, for their commitment to their profession and their commitment to our students. May they be encouraged by the opportunity that they have had to prepare these graduates to be the very best in their profession. We give thanks, O God, for the sacrifices of loved ones who have helped to make this day possible. We give thanks for our graduates, for what they have received and for what they have given to Howard University. We pray that they will always cherish the people, the teaching moments, and the friendships they have found on these grounds. We pray that these graduates will continually give the very best of their heart, their mind, and their soul to the dental profession, remembering always that for whom much is given, much is required. Bless now the works of their hands and their minds. In your name we pray, amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is really a high honor and privilege to present to you the 16th president of Howard University, Dr. Sidney A. Rabot.
Thank you very much, Dean Rouse. This is indeed an exciting time for all of us here at Howard University. We have a number of commencement ceremonies going on simultaneously. I think I will have participated in 12 by the end of the day today in the last day and a half, and culminating in the major commencement activity tomorrow afternoon out in the yard, where we have 2,200 students will be graduating. But I wanted to stop by personally to as many of the individual ceremonies as I could to bring my personal greetings and congratulations to all of the graduates and to their families and all of the people that have allowed this wonderful day to take place. The journey towards a degree in dentistry or in dental health is a long journey. It's a journey that really requires that you go through hurdles, you climb hills, you walk through cracks on the road, but out of the other end of that journey comes a professional, a healthcare professional, in this case a dental health professional, that really is prepared to serve, to give back, and to make a difference in their communities and their societies in this world. I'm particularly proud of the 129-year history of our College of Dentistry. The commitment that we have made historically to healthcare disparities and trying to assure that everyone has access to quality healthcare. We are the fifth oldest dental school in America, and a dental school that's been serving long and serving proudly on behalf of all the people that need access to our care and our support and our preparation. Providing quality health care is critically important, and in this era of health care debates, you can rest assured that the dental school and Howard University will always come out on the side of health care and access for health care for those who are in greatest need. Graduates, you are prepared to go on to the next stage of your journey, a very important journey. You've been prepared well by this excellent faculty here at Howard University. We're proud of you, we wish you well, and we look to hear from you soon about the wonderful things that you accomplish in your career. Congratulations.
Dr. Higginbottom is the Senior Vice President and Executive Dean for Health Sciences at Howard University, and my boss, Dr. Higginbottom.
Thank you, Dean Rouse. Good afternoon, everyone. Friends, colleagues, faculty, honored guests, and to the class of 2010, congratulations. I bring you greetings and salutations from the entire Health Sciences family. It is an honor to be part of this occasion today. It is a pleasure to see so many family and friends here because these are the supporters that you had these last few years. So I ask you now to applaud your supporters because you are here because they supported you. So let's pay it forward. Thank you. There are many, many outstanding individuals here with you who totally believe in you and your new role as a healthcare professional. The new era of healthcare brings many challenges. Some we know and others we do not. There are challenges across the spectrum as underserved communities lose far too many lives too early, too often. Oral health remains an opportunity for the entire healthcare community, the entire health professional community to take on, particularly given its role if less than optimal health, oral health, leads to serious systemic disease. Dean Rouse and our legendary faculty have prepared you very, very well to take your rightful leadership in today and tomorrow's patient care. You are our future, and we wish you well as you embark on the most exciting new phase of your professional and personal lives. We only ask that you remember your days here at Howard University and return often to see us and spend time with those who believe in you. Congratulations.
From the National Dental Association. A Howard alum of the class of 1975, their president, our president, Dr. Walter Owens. Walter.
Good afternoon, and class of 2010, I bring you greetings from the National Dental Association. This is a great honor for me to stand before you because not too many years ago, I sat where you sit. And I have a complete understanding, having practiced in an underserved community, the challenges that await you. I bring you greetings and support from the National Dental Association, your advocate for service and oral health care for the underserved populations of this country. I would like to give you a charge as you go forth. And one is to support Howard University. Howard University depends on you to give back to it because you have received so much from this institution. I also charge you to support organized dentistry because we are your advocates. The landscape in healthcare and particularly in oral health is changing very rapidly, and you do need an advocate to support and to follow legislation and to advocate for legislation that will benefit the profession and the population as a whole. I also charge you to pursue your profession with great ethics. We depend upon you to do the right thing, not only by your patients, but by the community of healthcare as a whole. Also, I'd like to acknowledge the fact that the National Dental Association will be recognizing senior Justin Cole, a senior student showing outstanding proficiency in general dentistry. And it is a particular honor for me to be able to perform the swearing-in. Of course, you know that the National Dental Association depends upon you, because without you, we would not be able to continue the leadership that we have carried out for 97 years advocating for underserved populations to make sure that the health care of those who sometimes are voiceless is spoken for on the levels where those issues can be addressed properly. I'd like to ask all the seniors to stand, please, and raise your right hand. When I say I will ask for you to repeat your name. I do solemnly swear to uphold the Constitution and bylaws of the National Dental Association to the best of my ability, to so help me God. Congratulations and Godspeed, and I'll ask you to continue your organizational affiliation with the National Dental Association throughout your professional life. Thank you.
From the Robert T. Freeman Dental Society, which is a constituent society of the National Dental Association here in Washington, D.C., another Howard man, Dr. Fred Clark. Fred?
Good afternoon. My name is Dr. Frederick Clark, president of the Robert T. Freeman Dental Society. Some of you know me, some of you don't. Some of you actually spent some time in my office. Some days were good, some days were not, but I hope that it was a good experience. Robert T. Freeman Dental Society represents the Metropolitan Washington chapter of the National Dental Association. I wish to thank Dean Rouse and the Howard community for allowing me a few minutes to address the distinguished graduates of the College of Dentistry, class of 2010. Let me say first, congratulations on your achievements and entry into a new world. It is one of uncertainty with our current economic situations, yet you need not despair because you have already exhibited a quality which will guide you to a successful future, and that quality is called leadership. First, you became a dentist, but your growth and development is not over. Now you must become a dental leader. As you leave Howard University, we bestow upon you your membership into the Robert T. Freeman Dental Society. The first year is at no charge. This will allow you to begin to take the reins of leadership through organized dentistry, which will help to guide you through the first few years after graduation when you will need guidance. Robert T. Freeman Dental Society offers this direction and guidance and camaraderie with members of the dental community who have gone before you. We can help to smooth out some of those rough and difficult spots that you're going to encounter. We will teach you and allow you to cultivate those leadership qualities that you already possess. I stand waiting and ready to assist you at any time in any way that I can. So feel free to call upon me at any time, and any member of Robert T. Freeman or the National Dental Association. Thank you very much, and again, my sincerest congratulations.
For the American Dental Association and the District of Columbia Dental Association, Dental Society, we have Dr. Paul Grogan, who's the president-elect. As you see, ladies and gentlemen, we have organized dentistry represented today, and to have these graduates appreciate what their role will be upon graduation to become involved, become advocates, as you've heard from Dr. Clark and Dr. Owens to point. And so Dr. Paul Grogan. Paul?
Dean Rouse, faculty, graduates, and guests, it's an honor for me as president-elect of the District of Columbia Dental Society and as a member of the ADA to stand before the graduating classes today. On behalf of the DC Dental Society, I offer you our heartiest congratulations. This is a great time to be in dentistry. I remember listening skeptically to speeches much like the one I'm giving right now and the ones you've just heard and thinking, sure, organized dentistry is going to be there and have my back. And I'm here to tell you that that is true. I had the privilege to attend the ADA National Political Meeting in Honolulu last October, and I'm here to tell you that it's really exciting to see the political clout that we in organized dentistry now have. I'm seeing in a few short months some of the legislation that we put in by our local dental society and how things have already changed nationwide the way dentistry is being practiced right now. So organized dentistry does indeed have our backs, and we need your input in the future. Once you guys leave Howard and you all go your separate ways, the support system that you've had for the past 4 years or so will be gone. You've learned to lean on each other for support and camaraderie, and that's what organized dentistry is here for. According to the statistics, 90% of you guys are going to enter into private practice, and 75% of those will be in solo practice. So you'll be on your own, an islander, stuck in the back of your office, back in molar land, and you'll need some other type of different support system. This is where organized dentistry comes in. After I graduated from dental school, I went into practice and became involved almost immediately. Soon after joining, I met colleagues who were in the same situations I was in. We were able to talk about cases, treatment plans, dental products, employment problems, and a host of other topics. And now, years later, we still have the same discussions with a lot of newer faces joining in all the time. Your local dental society provides monthly continuing education meetings, an annual educational meeting each spring, which I know some of you guys have already attended. The ADA is the largest dental organization in the world with nearly 157,000 members. This strength in numbers allows us at the ADA and its component societies to be strong advocates for dentists. The national, state, and local rules and laws are constantly being monitored and changed with our guidance to help ensure that we are able to practice dentistry the best way possible, and that most importantly, our patients receive the best care. Educate and advocate is the theme of organized dentistry. You as young dentists are the backbone of our dental societies. We need your participation so that we can keep up with the needs of your generation and help ensure that the world's finest dentistry is always practiced in the USA. Good luck, best wishes for the healthy and happy, prosperous career. Thanks.
This next individual is very special to me. She's a personal friend, the president of the Howard University College of Dentistry Alumni Association. She's also a poet laureate. She hails from New Jersey, as I do. I bring to you, ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Beverly Murdoch.
As a caterpillar transforms into the magnificent monarch butterfly, you are transforming into dreamed and coveted professionals, which just mere years ago was a vision. I had the pleasure of meeting one of the most prolific advisors and mentors of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., the late Dr. Samuel Proctor, Professor Emeritus of Rutgers University. He spoke during a baccalaureate service for graduating high school students on the topic of resumes, and his initial question was, "What will your resume say about you?" My question to each of you, RDH, DDS, and postgrads is, what will your curriculum vitae say about you? It will be filled with your professional history, your gifts to the world of your excellence, your aspirations, your hobbies, and the like. However, under the heading of alma mater support, I pray that there will be an entry for the Howard University College of Dentistry. You are among the over 3,000 HUCD graduates of this august institution. We need the brilliance that you have possessed toward this completion to shine through to those who travel in your pathway. We need your technical savvy and expertise as we strive to increase our status on the ever-expanding information and communications highway. We need your physical presence to grow and maintain the HUCD Alumni Association. We need your financial commitment to enhance our scholarship fund and physical plant items within the walls of HUCD. Please remember you have a coveted seat at our family table. We need you today, tomorrow, and in perpetuity. All of you have been granted a gratis first-year membership in the HUCD Alumni Association and will receive a certificate denoting this membership. Do not take this lightly. Your voice is needed as we enhance our foundation and build this association in our quest to surpass limitless boundaries to improve dental care for the masses and to serve as a constant support of our alums. We are staunchly proud of your efforts and bid you Godspeed and congratulations as you fly away from this moment in happiness, in peace, and in joy. Welcome to the other side. Now, I would like to say that we are giving you all a certificate of membership for the first year in the Alumni Association. And we expect all of you to give us something back. If it is only to allow us to know where you are initially. Please do help us. And I'm going to take a poetic moment to just tell you that we've got the whole world in our hands. Our efforts appear seamless to others, but they do not see, cannot comprehend the minutes, hours, days, and years needed to obtain excellence. It is our calling. They know we are dentists, but fewer understand we are doctors too. We are financial analysts, counselors, psychologists, artists, magicians, a confidant, a community voice of conscience, a banker, a philanthropist, a sculptor, an engineer, a comma in a series of periods, an educator, an aesthetician, a disciplinarian, an events planner, an employer, and a business person. Sitting chairside, as the postman does, through rain, snow, tornadoes, ice storms, and the like, we are there. Through fear, uncertainty, a rhinovirus, fractured limbs, we are there. Through the mourning of a loved one's funeral, we are there. The afternoon before a child's wedding, we are there. As long as we soothe the pain, bond a fractured tooth, or repair the broken denture, they remain happy. We must be ubiquitous like water, timeless as Father Time, resilient, undemanding, dependable, quick to heal, always available, impeccable in spirit, unquenchable in thirst, to continue on a relentless sojourner, going where the fearless handpiece will travel. We are workaholics, outlasting the very best. We quest the tangible spirit of excellence and are unsatisfied until we obtain perfection. Our artistic eye, guided by the one above, presents the final masterful product. Our praise is assured when one cannot tell the difference between God's gift and ours. We have chosen this road less traveled and revel in the results. Our gifts satiate the world of our patients and the community at large. In one quiet moment, we realize, because of it all, despite it all, through it all, we've got the whole world in our hands. Congratulations and all the best to you.
So bring your greetings now from the DC Dental Hygienist Association, another Howard alum, Ms. Yolanda Josie Baker. Josie.
Good afternoon. I am honored to bring greetings and congratulations from the DC Dental Hygienist Association to the graduates of the dental hygiene class of 2010. I had the pleasure to be with them a few nights ago as they participated in their pinning and candle lighting ceremony. This celebration was their passage from student hygienist to dental hygiene professional. To the graduates, today I want to encourage you to continue your professional growth through lifelong learning and to know that your national association that represents the interests of all dental hygienists across the country is here to help you. In case you don't know, that organization is the American Dental Hygienists Association. After you pass your boards, I encourage you to join. The ADHA is the only member association for you that is one-stop shopping for empowering, developing, and supporting you in promoting dental hygiene care to the public with the highest standards of education and practice. This is an exciting time to be entering the profession of dental hygiene. With the passing of the healthcare reform bill and the changing workforce models that will allow for the hygienist to perform expanded procedures in alternative settings, we are poised to be a viable force in shaping policy and protecting the health of the public. We must continue to be a participant and have our voice heard in this ever-changing healthcare debate. Your association needs your energy and ideas so that we continue to promote our collective goals and be advocates for better care and access to care for the public we serve. The public needs our valuable and irreplaceable knowledge and care. Remember, Howard University has prepared you for your professional career. Your professional association will prepare you for the challenges of providing care in this ever-changing environment. Again, congratulations and welcome to the dental hygiene profession.
Now, this is a time when I just really get so excited because we're going to be treated to a musical selection by Ms. Pamela Ward. Pamela is the daughter of Ms. Janet Bailey, who's one of our staff, support staff members in the college. And so prepare yourselves to really get that.
Say thanks for all the things He has done for me. Things so undeserved, yet You gave to prove Your love for me. The voices of a million angels could not express my gratitude. All that I hope for and long to be, I yield to Thee. Thank you.
reminded by what one of the students told me. I told her one day, I'm old enough to be your father. And she says, oh, you mean my grandfather? She's probably about right. Omicron Kappa Epsilon was founded in 1914 at Northwestern University by a group of students who were promoting scholarship and character. Pi Pi Chapter was founded at Howard University in 1948. At this time, I would like the inductees, student inductees, to come forward and line up at the stage. And as I call your name, you will come forward to receive your certificate and medallion. Please come forward. The first name is Brianna Allen. Justine Cole. Kristen Copeland. Melvin Dillard, the third. Alexis Russell.
I see you, Alexis. That's my woman.
Ashley Seals. Sean Smith. Kent Washington. These students have achieved outstanding academic and clinical performance. On occasions, not frequently, we like to select a faculty member who has demonstrated excellence in academics and clinical achievement. And this year, we have selected Dr. Michael Good.
Class of 2010 class president, dentistry, the class of 2010 president, dental hygiene, and our student council president. So I would call first Dr. Jacinta Watkins. Jacinta, please come.
Good evening, everyone, and especially my classmates, the class of 2010. I'm absolutely absolutely honored and humbled to even be able to speak today on such a memorable day, not only for the class of 2010, but for our faculty members, our staff, our supporting staff, our administrators, who have all assisted us to get to this exciting day. Now, I have several individuals that I would like to recognize for thank yous, and I'm praying that I get through this without shedding a tear. But I first would like to thank God for this opportunity, for this amazing thing that we call life, for having the opportunity to live every single day as if it was my last day. I want to thank my parents, who finally got here. I saw them strolling not too long ago. My mother, my father, my brother, my godparents, and granny and grandpa who were not present, and then my aunts and uncles, I believe they came as well. But I appreciate them for always teaching me to never give up and never surrender, and to treat everyone the way that I would like to be treated. I would also like to thank my personal advisors. Those would be my friend Celeste, my friend Gina, Derek, Shawana, Will, Alexis, Gary, Sultan, Denise, Dorothy, Melvin, so many of my classmates. I would not be here and wouldn't have been able to maintain my sanity if you were not here with me. And I appreciate that. I'm forever grateful for what you poured into my life and for always being supportive for me on my good days and on my bad days. I'd also like to thank Dean Rouse for always telling me to keep smiling and for telling me what DDS really stands for. Not gonna say that one. I want to thank Dr. Skinner. Your smile has always been just so kind and so sweet, and it's always a wonderful encouragement to just continue to keep working. No matter how bad the day is, Dr. Skinner is always smiling, and I always appreciate that. I'd like to thank all the faculty members. There's so many of y'all that are here. I wish I could list all of your names, but you know who you are, and I appreciate you letting me come to your office, introducing me to wonderful friends, Dr. Good. I appreciate that. And, you know, just being able to talk and have a conversation with you and be able to support me to be here at this wonderful, wonderful day. And, of course, I'd like to thank my class executive board, Donja Scott, Paula, for having our money together. We're able to do so many things with her. Shakara, Ashley, Tim, Stella, all my past E board members, I really appreciate all your help, and our class would not be as organized as we are if we did not have you present. Now, everyone in the class of 2010, please stand. Everyone, the day has arrived. We are here. We won the fight. We still have a little bit of fighting to go, but that's all right. We'll get the fight done, it's okay. So we're here, we are here. We are here. As many times as we've wondered and questioned and doubted and prayed to God, please let me get this complete denture patient. Can this partial denture please come back tomorrow? We've prayed, we've been here, and our day is here. So the class of 2010, I want to congratulate you. I'm so proud of you. Made me all so very proud. And I hadn't forgotten the song that we're going to sing that I told you earlier. So I'm not a good singer. The class is going to sing something really briefly. It's not like a long song, but I'll go ahead and leave. You guys back me up, okay, as you always have. We are the champions, my friend. And we'll keep on fighting to the end. We are the champions. We are the champions. No time for losers, 'cause we are the champions of the world. much is required. I wish you all the best. I wish you much success. And as always, God bless. Thank you.
All right, Ms. Diane Cohen, the president of the Class of 2010 Dental Hygiene Class.
Good afternoon, faculty, staff, dental hygiene alumni, students, and most of all, our loved ones. I present to you the Class of 2010 Dental Hygiene, Class of the Dimes. Dental hygiene is a service to the community in fulfillment of the basic human needs of oral health, including education, prevention, and treatment of oral disease. We believe that each individual, regardless of age, sex, race, creed, or ethnic background, has an inherent right to receive preventative services. Dental hygiene care should be directed toward the patient as an individual, encompassing their unique needs. Access to care being available is top priority for us. We now have the education to reach levels that were unreachable. The journey has been challenging, but now we have the power to educate as many as we encounter. With the knowledge that we have attained, we can now be clinicians, advocates, change agents, and educators. We as hygienists will conquer the world to educate as many individuals as we can to promote healthy mouths, which equals healthy bodies. It is not one entity, they go hand in hand. This is our beginning to many opportunities and a lifetime of learning. The sky is the limit. To all of our families, thank you so much for your support that you have provided, allowing us to be full-time students and half-time members of our families. This was an opportunity of a lifetime for us to be accepted into this strenuous program. We needed all of you. We are free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we're free at last. We had numerous community service hours to complete. In the beginning, there were requirements. In the end, they became a part of us. We tried to change everything that we did into community service. We had great experiences. We were exposed to different communities, with the ability to serve the fortunate and the less fortunate. Each experience was a lesson learned. Some of the many events included Give Kids a Smile Day. The first year, we educated. The second year, we participated. We provided radiographs if necessary, prophies, sealants, and oral hygiene instructions. We are educators, so oral hygiene instructions is provided at all times. Some additional events that we participated in were dental health fairs. We cleaned the school for accreditation with enthusiasm. We stuffed bags at the American Dental Hygiene Association annual meetings, which allowed us to interact with other dental hygiene students in our community. We marched onto Capitol Hill to support the Children's Defense Fund. We participated in annual dental meetings along with taking the continuing education courses to promote lifelong learning. We celebrated each other's birthdays. We attended social events together. We are a close group of students. 2 years ago, we all came together as strangers, sharing a common goal to become registered dental hygienists. We have formed friendships and bonds that will last a lifetime. Tonight, we have attained our goal, and for that, you should be so proud. I encourage each of you to continue your education. We're not finished yet. I commend you for completing a rigorous program of study in dental hygiene. You are now poised to become valuable members of the healthcare community. I want to wish you well as you enter your new profession. All of your hard work and dedication has paid off. Enjoy. I am honored and proud to have had the opportunity to represent a group with so much knowledge, prestige, and class. All of you have a special place in my heart and will never be forgotten. Without all of you, this would not have been such a successful finish for all of us. We needed each other from day one, and we still have each other now. I thank each and every one of you, and I will never forget the wonderful challenges that we encountered. May God continue to bless each and every one of you. I will keep you in my thoughts and prayers, and I love you.
Dr. Chaudhry, the President of Student Council. Sultan.
Good afternoon. My name is Sultan Chaudhry, and I would appreciate laughter after everything I say. Thank you. On behalf of Howard Dental's graduating classes, Hygiene, Doctoral, and Postdoctoral, I would like to thank the faculty, the staff, the administration, the parents, the family, the friends, and the three people who paid me in advance to mention their names in this speech, Colin Reed, Kunal Amrute, and Dean Skinner. But seriously, we are in the presence of a truly accomplished class. We have been through quite a journey, not just the last few years, but throughout our lives. And this moment is a symbol of that journey. My friends, it was roughly 25 years ago when we first set foot into a school for the first time. Uncertain about the future at that innocent age, we concerned ourselves with the simpler things in life. A is for apple. A ball is round, don't eat glue. Elementary school's most nerve-wracking moments were spelling bees or spelling tests and which superhero to choose on the outside of your lunchbox. At the end, we had a graduation, most likely in a cafeteria stage, where we all sang something together, in unison but completely off-key, with our parents hoping to get just one picture of us not staring off into space or without a finger in our nose. And then came middle school. And with it came literature, reading, geography, and of course, science. It was our first real exposure to the subject. We learned about the periodic table, the cell's organelles, and the laws of physics. Science as a whole seemed pretty simple. Boy, were we naive. We had no idea at that point how much science remained in our future. Next came high school. We upgraded our images. We moved away from trapper keepers, and we wore book bags on one shoulder. We stopped watching shows like Saved by the Bell, or at least publicly talking about them. We had lockers, a specified lunch hour, and we had to do book reports. Now, we thought that once we graduated from high school, we would never see those things again. But can we really complain? Here at the Howard University College of Dentistry, we went from having one locker to having three. We have a longer lunch time. And while there is a strict uniform code, instead of doing book reports on the American classics, we did reports on the epic struggle of good and evil, sin and temptation, and the relentless pursuit of victory in age-old sagas like Who Moved My Cheese? In high school, we took the SAT. A 3.5-hour retrospectively short exam relative to our 2-day-long board exams, and we came to college, away from home for the first time. We took course after course in anything under the bio section. We had finals and papers, and we still found time to become culinary experts in the art of ramen noodle. It was all in preparation to apply to dental school. And while all of us may not have known dentistry was in our future in our freshman year, we certainly questioned our decision towards this career path when we sat down for the first time with a DAT book. Now, the DAT covered organic chemistry, plant and animal biology, and trigonometry, all of which took weeks to study for, none of which are ever mentioned again in your life. But if a day ever comes where you have to rank 4 pixelated angles, each practically identical to the next, or guess how many holes are punched into a folded piece of paper to save someone's life, you will be successful. Now, after the DAT came the day where all of us interviewed here at Howard University. 2010, let's think back to when we first got here. When I first set foot in this school, I was unsure of what to expect. My interview group had about a dozen applicants, some of whom I saw again at orientation, all of whom I viewed as competition. I was lucky enough to be interviewed by the very non-intimidating professor, Dr. Fargason. Now, Dr. Fargason asked me quite a few questions, some of which I may not have been 100% honest about, so allow me to set the record straight. Maybe I should get my diploma first. He first asked, why dentistry? And I said, because dentistry provides an excellent opportunity to not only help others, but to employ one's artistic capabilities to oftentimes remove people from pain and discomfort while promoting a healthy lifestyle. But what I meant to say was, dentistry provides an excellent opportunity to not only help others, but also to employ one's artistic capabilities to oftentimes remove people from pain and discomfort while promoting a healthy lifestyle and make a lot of money. Dr. Fargason then asked me what innovations in dentistry interest me. Without even a moment to process the question, I spoke at length about microimplants and electrocauterization surgery in addition to Invisalign and palatal modification to enhance weight loss. But that's only because I have a very loving family member who helped me prepare for the interview, and it just so happens that my uncle is a practicing dentist in Northern Virginia, superdentist.com. All right. Finally, Dr. Fargason asked me how I would be an asset to Howard Dental. Now, I don't remember exactly what I said, but I'm guessing it was something along the lines of, one day I will be president of this class, and I will give the graduation speech, and I will speak about you at length at my graduation speech. Because shortly thereafter, I received my letter of admission. Now, when I came to orientation week, I expected to meet a diverse group of people with very unique backgrounds. One of the first persons I met was Amna. And I thought to myself, glancing at her folder with the same last name, Chaudhry, as mine, really unique. We're in a very small class and there's already multiple Chaudhrys. And even though we'd get asked by professors if we were related, if we were brother and sister or cousin, and when my hair was longer one time by Dr. Grower, he asked if we were sisters. The point is, we all grew as a class. We all grew as a school to find colleagues, friends, and for Will and Alexis, a little bit more than that, that's okay. Four years later, as we approach the end of our educational career, and for those of you going into oral surgery, the halfway point of your educational career, we should pause and reflect on the accomplishments we have achieved, and how that none of it would have been possible without that childhood friend who was always there for you, or that sibling who was never too busy, or that teacher who believed in your potential and helped nurture it to shape you into the distinguished person that you are today. But mostly, we should pause to reflect that none of this would have been possible without the help of God, because God gave us our biggest blessing, and it isn't the successful board exams, it's not the dental school admission, and it's not even my beautiful hair. God's biggest blessing to us was providing us with loving parents and role models who were there for us every step of the way, with sincere joy for us on our best days and relentless support for us on our worst.
Face and face the audience and recognize your loved ones. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay. Thank you very much. Turn back this way. Thank you. Dental hygiene, postdocs, you all may sit. Pre-docs, please remain standing. In the white envelope is the dentist's pledge. Repeat after me. I repeat your name. I, as a member of the dental profession, shall keep this pledge and these stipulations. That I understand and accept that my primary responsibility is to my patients. I want you to do an about face and face the audience and recognize your loved ones. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay. Thank you very much. Turn back this way. Thank you. Dental hygiene, postdocs, you all may sit. Pre-docs, please remain standing. In the white envelope is the dentist's pledge. Repeat after me. I repeat your name. I, as a member of the dental profession, shall keep this pledge and these stipulations. That I understand and accept that my primary responsibility is to my patient, and I shall dedicate myself to render to the best of my ability the highest standard of oral health care, and to maintain a relationship of respect and confidence. Therefore, let all come to me safe in the knowledge that their total health and well-being are my first considerations. That I shall accept the responsibility that as a professional, my competence rests on continuing the attainment of knowledge and skill in the arts and sciences of dentistry. That I acknowledge my obligation to support and sustain the honor and integrity of the profession, and to conduct myself in all endeavors such that I shall merit the respect of my patients, colleagues, and my community. I further commit myself to the betterment of my community, for the benefit of all of our society, that I shall faithfully observe the principles of ethics and code of professional conduct set forth by the profession. All this I pledge with pride in my commitment to the profession and the public it serves. Thank you very much. Please be seated.